Project Breathe is a great opportunity for us to look at how we can use technology to start to change the way we think about healthcare.
Cystic fibrosis is the most common genetic disease in the UK. Impacts people in a number of different ways. The one that most people are familiar with is difficulty with the lungs and mucus in the lungs, but it can impact people in different ways, problems with the digestive system and the reproductive system as well. People with CF can be taking 50, 60, 70, 80 tablets a day with a drugs regime. There's also the physiotherapy. The burden of care is one of the biggest concerns. The amount of time travelling to hospital appointments, the amount of time taking drugs, the amount of time doing physiotherapy, if you're at school or working, what the rest of us would use for spare time isn't spare time for people with cystic fibrosis.
My name is George, and my favourite thing about being 12 is that I can go out and meet up with my mates after school. Gaming is one of my favourite things to do, and I do it a lot of the time. I have CF, and the medication I have to do and like the treatments I have to do are annoying, and I wish I didn't have to do them, but I hate my physio. It's really boring, it's long, it's...
The organisation realised a few years ago that with Internet of Things, mobile phones, increasing number of devices to capture measurements, there was potential to do something very different to see if the promise of these technologies can actually be translated into meaningful change in people's lives.
The opportunity with the CF Trust is to work with subject matter experts who know their field inside out, and from our role as experienced designers, as technologists, to start to determine how we can bring these two different perspectives together and work with a whole range of other stakeholders as well to change the existing reality for people with CF and look at how technology can make a tangible, measurable difference to the outcomes that we seek.
So I was incredibly inspired by the work that Microsoft Research have been doing around the gamification of physiotherapy treatments for people with cystic fibrosis. My younger son has cystic fibrosis, and it was an obvious choice for me to use my skills to actually make a real difference.
We started talking with people who we thought might be able to help, and here we are running a hackathon. We're talking to the CF Trust, and I think we've got a great chance to deliver some compelling technology, some great experiences, you know, that might drive some improvements in healthcare, some direct benefits for patients.
So what we're hoping to do is take lots and lots of connected devices, whether that's weighing scales, whether that's spirometers, and actually enable them to collect data from a CF patient. This can be done remotely, and there's no need to get well people into the hospital.
It's like an anecdote we talk about internally, where a senior physician basically said, of the 10 people I see in any one day, 8 of them I didn't need to see, and 2 of them I should have seen 3 weeks ago. And I think where we think remote monitoring and technology can really help is, you know, those 2 people come to hospital earlier, potentially get treated for an infection earlier, don't end up spending a month in hospital on intravenous antibiotics. The other 8, they've got that additional time in their lives to do homework, to do football, you know, whatever they want to get on in their lives, and, you know, having a life unlimited by CF.
By storing our personal health data in Health Vault, we have a great opportunity to start to harness the power of machine learning and advanced analytics. I start to see more potential applications for the work that we're doing, more people who could benefit from this work, not just the patient and not just Microsoft, you know, but the NHS, clinicians, research teams, charities. It's a really exciting piece of work to be talking about. I think involvement of charities like the CF Trust is really critical. We demonstrated through the work that we've done with the guide dogs in the UK just how important it is to get the real story, to get the real facts, to learn and engage directly with patients. Those are things that it's very difficult for us to do on our own.
I think one of the really exciting things about working with a major tech company is they'll have the access to technical resources. We can bring to that an understanding of the condition, the disease, but also potentially access to key stakeholders.
The technology is all there. You know, we've got this really fabulous opportunity not to try and invent something that's completely new, which is very difficult, but really to harness a lot of technology that's already in the marketplace. And I think as a services business, what we're really good at is picking up that technology and joining it together to produce great experiences and great outcomes.
Once we've proven this architecture and approach for for the CF community. This can broaden out in many different directions. More devices, more patients, more data, but also more conditions, whether that is asthma, whether that's COPD, whether that's emphysema, and all of those will benefit from this same infrastructure.
I think the Trust is incredibly excited by where technology is going. I think the limitation for us is we're a small organisation, there's a limited number of people in the organisation who understand technology. So being able to partner with large technology companies is invaluable for us. And the reality is machine learning, big data, Internet of Things are going to transform medical care over the next 20 years. And we've got to try to be at the forefront of that, but also measured in our involvement as well.
The great opportunity for Microsoft is, as we continue our journey of transformation, is being able to demonstrate how this is helping us realise our mission to enable every person on the planet to achieve more. And in particular, showing how technology can be an enabler in that role and that responsibility.